series of these implants are placed in order to create an anterior channel through the prostate. On average, and it depends on the size of the prostate, we put in 4 to 5 implants for each patient. And typical procedure, the actual deployment of the scope and the placement of the implants typically is less than 10 minutes in the office. The implant itself is composed of a nitinol capsular tab and a stainless steel urethral end piece and permanent suture. So these are materials that are commonly used in surgery and inert. The nitinol does contain a nickel product. What it allows, mechanically opens the prostatic urethra. So you say before, you have the obstruction of the lateral lobes of the prostate, and afterwards, disobstruction, essentially immediate disobstruction by placing the implants. We see the result visibly under cystoscopy in real time. We place the implants in an anterior lateral position, we like to say at 3 and 9 o'clock positions, in the urethra. And in that way, it avoids the neurovascular bundles and the dorsal venous complex. It has been extremely well studied. As far as any treatment for BPH goes, it's probably had the most rigorous study and also a fast FDA approval compared to other currently available treatment options. The ones I'm going to focus on today, the studies I'm going to focus on today are the LIFT study that started in 2013, the 5-year data was recently published, the local study, the BPH-6 study, which compares the UroLift to a transurethral resection of the prostate. You know, in terms of insurance coverage, it's covered by Medicare, Kaiser, most PPOs except I think Blue Cross of California and the HMOs in town covered as well. Multiple peer-reviewed publications, extremely well studied. The main focus of today's talk is the LIFT study. This was a multi-institutional randomized controlled trial where the control was sham-treated patients. So this, all the patients were treated in the office under a local anesthetic, except for one patient that had a sedation. 206 patients, 2-to-1 randomization. The actual sham procedure, and this was blinded to both subject and assessor, it involved placing a surgical screen between the patient and the urologist, and they developed kind of this Hollywood-style device delivery system. It was like a kind of a clapping device. So the patient that received the sham treatment and the assessor didn't know that they had the sham treatment. They thought that they had the actual implant, which is important because we know that a rigid cystoscopy will improve flow parameters for at least several weeks afterwards. There was data monitoring, clinical events committees, and independent reviewers for the outcomes of your flow and cystoscopy. So it was, the primary endpoint was designed to show a reduction in the AUA symptom score of more than 25%. It was blinded for 3 months. And then that was the blind study. The open label study was for a total of 5-year follow-up. What it showed is that in the first 3 months, it actually caused a greater than 88% improvement compared with that of control. And the 5-year data shows that essentially symptom relief is achieved rapidly within 2 weeks, and at 1 month it's very similar to what can be expected at 5 years, with the average improvement in symptom score being 11 points at 1 year and approximately 9 points at 5 years. It offers a fairly modest improvement in